Imagine a computer virus that you cannot remove even by wiping a hard drive completely or removing it altogether. Surely that can't be possible, right? Well, you might want to sit down for this one. There is a recently discovered exploit, it was discovered a couple months ago, that your computer is very likely to be vulnerable to. It's being called LogoFail, and it actually is a collection of several exploits having to do with your computer's BIOS firmware. To understand what the big deal is, let me give you a quick primer on firmware-level malware, which is kind of like the big final boss of malware. You see, regular malware and viruses, we kind of all know how they work. They usually install themselves and embed themselves in the operating system or in some files that gets auto-run when the computer starts up and then does whatever tracking or stealing. And if there's different levels of ways these viruses hide themselves, for example, rootkits might literally be starting up before anything else in the operating system, so it can't really be detected, or fileless malware is another example where it doesn't even have any files themselves on the drive. It kind of runs as a script that starts a process along with the operating system. But at the end of the day, you could wipe the drive and get rid of these. But the firmware, which is like embedded code within hardware itself, that is not stored on the drive anywhere. For example, we've all probably heard of the BIOS. These days, it's technically the UEFI, but everyone calls it the BIOS. That's what I'm going to call it. Anyway, that is going to be stored on a physical BIOS chip on the motherboard, and that's why it can run even if there's no drive installed on the computer. So in cases where the firmware is infected by malware, because that firmware code gets loaded before any other software, the operating system, drivers, anything else, then there's literally nothing that can stop it. It can do anything from reinstalling malicious files onto the drive repeatedly every time at boot up, or starting a process that is malicious that the operating system can't even see at all, therefore you can never detect it. And unfortunately, this LogoFail set of exploits does allow malware to infect the firmware itself. So first let me give you a quick overview of how this LogoFail thing works and why it's so bad, and then I can go into a bit more details. So you know when you boot up your computer, you're usually gonna see a logo of some kind. Maybe it's the manufacturer of the motherboard, or if it's a branded computer, you'll see the computer manufacturer logo comes up. And also, oftentimes, the BIOS may allow a user to actually customize what logo shows up, what image does. Well, turns out a company called Binarly discovered that the image parsers, which is like the bits of software that loads these images, they apparently have lots of exploits, and they're used by basically all the BIOS software companies. And the big takeaway is that a bad actor could create image files, regular image files that are encoded in such a way that when the bits of software load the image onto the BIOS, it can trick it into doing a lot more stuff, including just rewriting the firmware to have malicious code in there and doing whatever they want. And the reason this is especially bad is because, yes, there are actually technologies such as Secure Boot that are specifically designed to ensure that BIOS data is not manipulated on startup. But apparently they do not usually check the image files, which is how this is allowed to get through. So what would happen is you'd get infected with malware one way or the other, usually the typical way you download a file unknowingly, and instead of running a stealer or installing pop-ups or whatever, it will replace the image that gets loaded by the BIOS, and then your firmware is hacked. And then literally nothing will be able to detect it. Before I get into the details though, something else that's vulnerable is your personal data, which is where today's sponsor comes in, Aura. Sketchy data brokers out there collect and sell your information to scammers, spammers, and anyone else who may want to target you. I'm talking about your full name, email, home address, health records, your relatives, it's all out there. But that's where Aura comes in. For example, it can show me which data brokers are selling my info and automatically submit opt-out requests for me. Cleaning up all this info not only reduces the amount of spam coming my way, but protects me from hackers who might leverage this info to try and access my accounts or even send personalized phishing attacks. I was even surprised when it showed me that the collected public info out there even included what kind of car I drive. I was not expecting that. But Aura also has a ton of other features, such as antivirus, a VPN, password management, parental controls, even identity theft insurance, all in one place, instead of needing a bunch of separate apps. And even if you have one or two of these tools already, you could be still leaving doors open to bad actors. But Aura is always on, so you can have peace of mind and focus on the other important stuff. To get started and protect your info, you can go to aura.com/theojo to start your 2-week free trial. Link is also in the description. And with all that being said, let's continue. So in terms of more details about how the malware actually replaces the logo file, there's three main attack vectors that they could choose to use. And importantly, for two of these, it does not require the attacker to have physical access to your computer. It can be remotely hacked like any other virus. So I've seen people say, oh, well, don't worry, they have to have physical access to your computer. No, they do not. The first strategy they can use is to replace the file in the so-called EFI system partition. You see, these days, the UEFI, which is basically like an advanced version of the old BIOS, but people still call it the BIOS. Anyway, in addition to having the firmware, which boots up and can do stuff, they also usually load supplemental data onto the hard drive in a special EFI partition. It's very small, about 100 megabytes, and this will contain info about how to boot individual operating systems. So if you have a multi-boot system, usually it's all going to be stored in one place. And this EFI partition will have stuff like the bootloaders for the operating systems, but may also contain those logos. So what happens is you get some kind of malware that infects your computer, and either by tricking you into running it as admin or it does a privilege escalation attack, it gets the ability to simply write the malicious image file to this EFI partition. So it's literally just a matter of copying a file over. So what happens is the BIOS on startup will see that logo and load it and try to display it, but it has that malicious code, and then it'll manipulate the BIOS firmware, so it doesn't even need that logo again to run. It'll already be embedded in the firmware, and that's why if you erase the drive, it doesn't help anymore. Now, typically, this EFI system partition is protected by something like Secure Boot. That's what it does. It makes sure that none of these files are manipulated, different than the officially signed versions. But apparently, it turns out that there are sections of the EFI partition that are not checked. They're part of unsigned blocks, so it doesn't check everything. Apparently, the logo is part of that oftentimes. Next, the second attack vector would be through a malicious BIOS update file. So usually a computer is going to have a way where the user can update a BIOS file one way or another. And sometimes this even includes a tool that allows you to take a firmware update file and run it from within the operating system. As it's already running, you don't even have to reboot, and it'll update the firmware directly from within the OS. And usually this isn't really a problem security-wise, because the existing BIOS will check that the new BIOS file is signed correctly and hasn't been tampered with, and then only will it install it. But again, apparently part of these files are not actually checked and don't have to be signed, including a logo file. So what malware could do is take a legitimate BIOS update file and replace the part that doesn't get checked and replace that image file only in that part. So the actual code part, which used to be assumed to be the only part that matters security-wise, it won't be changed, and the BIOS will load everything from that file, including the image, and then that's when it'll get infected. Now, there is a third attack vector that does actually require using physical access, and in that case, you'd use something called a SPI flash programmer, where you literally connect pins and stuff. That is pretty advanced. In that case, you'd go directly to the hardware level and replace the file in there. That's probably not going to happen usually, and if someone has physical access to your computer, you're kind of screwed anyway, but it is an option nonetheless. Now, I'm sure at this point most of you are wondering how you can tell if your computer is vulnerable and what you can do to protect yourself. And first of all, it's probably easier to go over who is not vulnerable. First of all, Macs are not vulnerable. Even Intel-based Macs are not. That's because the Apple Silicon Macs don't use UEFI at all, and the Intel-based Macs have the image hard-coded in such a way that there is a check including on the image, so you can't replace it. Next, there are some Dell devices that are apparently not vulnerable because they use a additional type of technology, not Secure Boot, but it's called Intel Boot Guard, which actually is supported on most computers, but Dell has it configured in a special way where it also checks the image portion, whereas for a lot of computers, even if it does have Intel Boot Guard, they don't check the image. So apparently a lot of Dell computers are safe because it is covering the image. Next, from what I've read, MSI motherboards are also not vulnerable because they don't allow the user to change the logo, and the logo is included as part of the signed block of Intel Boot Guard. Although I haven't been able to find any official confirmation from MSI about this. And then again, MSI did have their Intel Boot Guard hardware keys leaked last year, so I mean, it's still better than nothing, I guess. In any other cases besides those, though, it is probably good to assume that you are vulnerable. The good news is that, as far as I know and have read, there haven't been any instances of this being actively used yet, but that doesn't mean that it won't be. And as for how to protect yourself, well, really the only true solution is to update your BIOS to the latest firmware, assuming that your system manufacturer created a BIOS update to cover this. By now, most motherboard and system manufacturers should have released a BIOS update if they were going to on more recent software. They said typically by early Q1 2024. Though again, for older systems, they might take longer if they're gonna do it at all. For example, if you look at recent BIOS updates from Asus and Gigabyte, they specifically mention these BIOS updates as patching the logo fail exploit. So that's something you would wanna look for your system. Although you always do have to be cautious when updating the BIOS. If you screw it up, like turning off the computer in the middle of it, it could really mess up your system. So if you really don't know what you're doing, maybe just look on the manufacturer's website, see if they have any detailed instructions on how to do it, or maybe ask one of your friends who's good with computers to do it. It's not super tough, but it's just that if it does go wrong, it can go really wrong. So yeah, it's pretty scary, and especially that not a lot of people probably know about this, but at least now you do, and you can potentially address it. So I would be curious to know what you guys think. Are you gonna bother updating the BIOS, or just take the risk? We can just talk about that down in the comments. Thanks again to Aura for sponsoring this video. If you want to protect your data and take advantage of all the other features it has, go to aura.com/theojo for a 2-week free trial, link in the description. So if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to keep watching, I made a video recently about some very tricky malware techniques hackers are using to even target programmers and Linux users. Usually you think they're pretty safe, but no. So I'll put that link right there you can click on. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.